A MAV lift is a self-propelled, mobile piece of equipment used by many glazing contractors to set glass, curtain wall, aluminum panels, or other materials. Before operating your MAV lift, please take a minute to study the load charts, safety placards, and operator's manual to ensure safe operating practices when operating the MAV lift. To turn on the MAV lift, insert the red battery disconnect key into the ignition on the base of the unit. Rotate to the on position. If the unit does not power on, check the e-stop switch located on the remote. Before operation, it is a good idea to check the battery level and counterweights for the MAV lift. The battery gauge can be found on the drive handle. Below the drive handle, locate the counterweight placard and verify that all counterweights are in place. When you are ready to use your MAV lift, please remember that after startup, the MAV lift requires the operator to calibrate or zero out the lift cylinders before it will allow the MAV lift to boom up. Zero out the cylinders by holding top right boom button down on the remote until the boom stops at its down limit. Once the MAV lift has been zeroed out, you may maneuver the MAV lift as needed. To drive the MAV lift, manipulate the drive controls on the handle on the unit. You will find a speed switch, throttle, horn, and safety button used to prevent accidental operator pinning. For convenience, the MAV lift has a smooth start function that keeps the machine from accelerating too fast when initially pressing the throttle controls. Although not required, it is a good idea to deploy the outriggers for added stability before you pick up glass or material. The outriggers are deployed by pressing the outrigger lock switch on the top of the outrigger and moving the outrigger into place until it locks in the deployed position. Once the outriggers are deployed, use the MAV lift remote to manipulate the suction frame. Manipulate multiple functions at one time for pro users or a single function for precision adjustments. As used to zero out the controls, the top row of buttons control the boom up and boom down function. The buttons on the second row of the remote may be used to control the tilt function along the horizontal plane. This function will allow glass or panels to be hoisted from the floor to the ceiling. Scope the boom in and out using the third set of buttons. Remember, when operating the MAV lift with the boom scoped out, to double-check the load chart to ensure a safe lift. For safety, the MAV lift is equipped with a tipping sensor, which will freeze the scope out function if the MAV lift reaches its load limit. But this should not be relied on in lieu of safe operation within the charted limits of the MAV lift. For fine adjustment of your glass or material left and right, use the remote's fourth row buttons. These buttons control the machine's side shift function and allow you to shift the machine up to 4 inches. Finally, if equipped, the buttons on the bottom row of the remote control are used to 45-degree rotate or slew the suction frame electronically. If the MAV lift is not equipped with electric slew or 45-degree rotate option, please disregard these controls. However, you may manually rotate and tilt the suction frame. To manually slew the suction frame, rotate the knob on the top of the frame joint. Slew the glass as desired and release the knob to lock the glass into place. To rotate the suction frame, depending on the MAV lift model, either pull or twist the black knob at the top of the frame joint and release to set. When using these functions while manipulating glass, please ensure that the frame is in a central position to neutralize the weight of the load before releasing the locks. This will make it easier to maneuver the glass and ensure smooth movements. If your glass requires the cups on the frame to be adjusted, rotate the black adjustment hand screws. Adjust the position of the cup and tighten the screws once the cup is in the desired position. The cups may be attached or detached from the suction hoses using the quick release hose disconnect system. Notice that the MavLift has two independent vacuum pumps and systems for increased safety during a lift. These systems are designated with either blue hoses or black hoses throughout. These colors also correspond to the appropriate vacuum gauge located on the MavLift handle. To engage the vacuum system, push forward the vacuum switch located on the top of the MavLift into the on position. Once the vacuum system charges, check the integrity of the system by looking at the gauges on the drive handle of the unit. To release pressure in the vacuum system, pull the vacuum safety knob and pull the vacuum switch into the off position. Although these videos are to aid you in the familiarization of the MavLift, please reference and follow all manufacturers' operating and safety recommendations. It is important to operate the MavLift in a safe manner at all times. It is important to travel slowly when maneuvering around obstacles and always maintain control of the unit.